Hi, this is Colleen, and welcome to Fieldwire. COVID-19 has changed the way we work. There's no face-to-face, and only the most essential people are on the job site, leaving most everyone else to be working from home or from a remote office. Today, I'll show you how to best manage your projects during this new normal. Whether you're working from home and trying to stay up to date on progress, or on the site and having to keep your remote team in the loop, Fieldwire will be your one source of truth and help move your project forward. For those of us who are still reporting to the job site, it's become even more essential to provide clear updates and to document progress. Today, we'll break that down into three sections: progress photos, deficiency tracking, and tracking the health and safety of your team all through Fieldwire. First, we'll cover what can be done from the field to ensure that your remote team is getting proper updates. You'll want to keep your remote team up to date on the progress of your project, which we can track right on the plan, and this is something we can easily accomplish with progress photos. Let's jump into the desktop version to set up my project for great progress photo tracking. I'll come to my Plans tab and create a new folder. Let's call it Progress Photos. Next, I'll upload the latest version of each of my floor plans. You won't need to keep these updated as long as the general layout of the floor plan remains the same and your team knows not to build off of this particular floor plan, since this plan is primarily just to show progress. I'll drag and drop my file into Fieldwire and wait for it to process. Because this particular floor plan has been uploaded before, Fieldwire is prompting me to slipsheet it. I want to keep this copy separate from the other versions of this plan, so I'm going to add onto the name. Let's add dash progress photos. Now that my plans are set up, I'm ready to head out in the field and take great progress photos. On your mobile device, scroll down to the progress photo folder and select the floor plan that you're ready to take photos of. Open up your markup toolbar and select the photo hyperlink. Tap the area of the plan you're going to take photos from, and then tap the hyperlink to start taking photos. Stand in one spot, facing one direction, and take a photo. Tomorrow, you'll stand in the exact same spot at around the same time and take a similar photo. Here are some tips and tricks. Tip number one: with your team, decide what time of day you'll want to take your progress photos. I suggest doing it first thing in the morning or in the afternoon before you head home for the day. Taking the photos at the same time every day will ensure that your updates are consistent and that your team knows when to expect them. Tip number two. Depending on your project, I suggest having one pin for each direction within each room. Your photos should all be taken from the exact same view, so you can clearly see which area is being shown and the exact progress that has been made. 360-degree photos are a great way to accomplish this as well, while allowing you to take fewer photos. Tip number three: if you enable location services, you'll be able to see the exact GPS coordinates of the photos when viewing them on web. Now let's talk about deficiency tracking. When most of our team is working remotely, we'll want to provide more updates. We can do this by taking photos and videos of the items when they arise, when they are being worked on, and once they're finished. This way, our remote team will know the exact status of the items and can jump in with questions along the way. Today, I discovered a damaged carpet tile that needs to be replaced, so I'm going to create a task on the plan to track the work. I'll title the task "Replace Damaged Carpet Tile," assign it to my tile foreman, Dan, and then put it in the flooring category. I'll take a photo and mark it up so Dan knows exactly where the issue is. Once Dan starts working on this issue, I'll update the start date and estimated completion date so my team knows about how long it'll take. Dan or I will take photos throughout the process to show the progress that's been made. Once it's complete, I'll add photos and videos to make sure the remote team feels like they are on site as well. I'll move this task to complete and assign it back to my PM who's working from home. To learn more about how you can use Fieldwire tasks for tracking deficiencies, check out this video. Now, on to health and safety tracking on site. Many companies are requiring new forms to be filled out to ensure the health and safety of their essential workers. If this is the case for you, you can utilize our custom forms feature to build a fillable form accessible from your tablet or computer. Check out our custom forms video to learn more about the creation of these templates. In this example, my company is requiring us to take and record the temperatures of all workers before they enter the job site. I've put this into my daily report so I never forget to enter the information and submit it at the end of the day. I'll create a new row within this table to track each person's temperature. In the afternoon, once my daily report is complete, I'll change the assignee back to be my project manager so that he gets a notification of completion. Then I'll change the status to be submitted so nobody else can make edits. Now, for those of you who are working from home or a remote office, here are some ways you can stay on top of what's happening out in the field. The first thing you'll want to do is sort through the progress photos taken the day before. You can do that in two different ways. Option 1. You can view progress photos plan by plan or floor by floor by going to the progress photos folder created by your team. Click on each hyperlink to view the progress in that specific area. Or option 2. Sort through photos from the Photos tab and see all of the photos taken within the last day. If there's something that stands out and seems particularly interesting or problematic, click the arrow to see the plan or task that the photo was taken from. Now on to deficiencies. Once I've reviewed yesterday's photos, I'll head to my task manager to view all of the tasks that were updated in the last day. I'll come to Filter Tasks and adjust it to show everything that was last modified in the last day. I'm particularly interested in the completed column, as these tasks are all awaiting my verification. Remember that only project admins have the ability to verify tasks. I'll review each of the completed tasks along with the photos and videos that my team took of the final product. If the items meet our quality standards, I'll drag and drop the tasks to verified. Remember, verified tasks become archived after a certain period of time, which is indicated in your settings tab. The last thing that I do every day is review the daily report from my superintendent. Right now, it is especially important that I sign off on the section that indicates that none of the workers on site have a high temperature. I'll review the work log, equipment log, any photos that are attached, and lastly, the temperature table. I'll throw my signature on the form and then email it out to my safety director. Thanks so much for joining me today. I hope we were able to help you find some more ways to use Fieldwire to work safely both on the site and remotely. To get more resources about how customers have been approaching working on projects during the COVID-19 pandemic, check out our resource hub. You'll find more information about on-site safety, remote work, taking care of your mental health, and more.